Hi student, welcome to botany class. Today we are going to see the third type of stem modification, that is underground stem modification. In the previous video we have discussed the aerial and the subaerial modification of stem. In the both the aerial and subaerial modified stem, it do not grow erect because they have the big stem. It's not grow erect. Erect means it's not grow stem because they have very big stem. So that's why it will be grow near the soil, that is terranean. Terranean means it will be grow near the soil, that is prostrate. In subaerial, it is subterranean. Subaerial or subterranean. That means the half of the stem it present above the soil and some part of the stem it present inside the soil. Either it will form the root or without root formation. That is a subaerial modified stem. Let's see the underground modified stem. Actually, the stem is a positively phototrophic. That means it grows towards the light. The direction of the growth is towards the light. But in some group of the plant, the stems are present inside the soil. That is negatively geotrophic. Only the leaf-like part, it will come out from the soil. It is formed from the node region. It will present inside the soil. And this bears the node, internode, terminal buds, axillary buds, and scale leaves. So these are present. And the nature of the root, like the root cap and the root hairs, are absent in the underground modified stem. So that's why this is considered as the modified stem. It's not a root, it is a stem. Why? Because it do not have root cap and the root hairs. Instead of that, what are the present in the structure? The node, internode, axillary and the terminal bud, that is apical buds, scale leaves. So these are present. So mostly the underground modified stem, it is meant for storage. And also it will be meant for vegetative propagator organ. It will mean for propagule, vegetative propagule. It will be live for many years inside the soil during the unfavorable condition. When the favorable condition will be bad, it will be formed a new plant body. So the underground modified stem is not only the purpose of the storage, and also it will be mean for, it is act as a vegetative propagule. So, propagule means it is an organ to produce a new young one. Okay, so let's see the underground modified stem. The perennial and some biennial plants. So, perennial means they will be grow every year. They produce flower and fruit for every year. That means, so this plant is live for many years. That is a perennial. It may be a monocarpic perennial or polycarp, whatever it may be. But perennial means they live for many years and produce a flower for each and every year. That is a polycarpic perennial. Now, monocarpic perennial, like Musa. You see the Musa. So, Musa, the perennating by means of rhizome. So, rhizome is a modified stem. So, they will be reproduced only once in their lifetime. After that, the new node region, it form a new the pseudostem. Okay, so it is a monocarpic perennial. In lifetime, it will reproduce only once in a the bambosa. It's a best example for monocarpic perennial. Biennial, they live for 2 years or 2 seasons. In the first year or first 2 seasons, the plant grow vegetatively. During second year or second season, they grow reproductively. So the perennial and some biennial herbs, herbspin, it's a small plant. They have very delicious, they do not have the woody stem. They have very soft stem, that is a herb, have the underground stem. So this group of the plant, perennial and some biennial, not all perennial, some of the perennial and some of the biennial plant, especially for herb, it's have the underground stem, which are generally known as rootstock. Which one? The underground stem is generally known as rootstock. So here we can use the term rootstock. It not mean for root. We clear that rootstock mean it's not mean for, it is a root. So it is a propagule. It had ability to form a new plant body during the favorable condition. So that's why this is a rootstock. So rootstock mean it's not mean for, it is a root. Okay, so it is a propagule. It will be form a new plant body during the favorable condition. The rootstock is function as a storage and protective organ. It will be preserve the next generation. It will be have the next generation. It remain alive below the ground during the unfavorable condition. Listen that. So rootstock is not mean for the root. It is live for many years during the unfavorable condition. They will be form a new plant body during the favorable condition. So it is meant for the storage and the production. It is a productive organ, rootstock. It resume the growth during the favorable condition. Which one? The rootstock. The rootstock will be resume. Resume means it will be again to form a new plant body during the favorable condition. When the favorable condition will be back, it will be again form a new plant body. The underground stem are not root. It is not a root. It is a stem. Why we call it a stem? Because it has the following character like node, internode, scale leaves and buds. So these all the things are present in the underground stem. So that's why it's not a root. It is a stem. Even though it's present inside the soil. Okay, so the underground part is a root. We already know that. The main plant body, the axis consists of two parts. One is present inside the soil and one is present outside the soil. So inside the soil region, there is a root. But here the stem also is present inside the soil, but it's not a root because it's at the following stem character like node, internode, scale leaves and the buds. The rootstock also lay root cap and the root has. We do not have. The rootstock do not have the root cap and the root has. So that's why it's not a root. It is a rootstock. It presents inside the soil. It is a propagule. It will be dormant during the unfavorable condition. Dormant means it do not do any function. Okay. So it is resumed like a dead nature. But when the favorable condition will be reback, the dormant condition will be break up or system it germinate to form a new plant body. So the rootstock do not have the root cap and the root has. They possess terminal buds. So buds mean both the axillary and terminal buds are present. Which are the characteristic features of the stem? Which one? The presence of the node, internode, the presence of scale leaves, buds, that is both axillary and terminal buds. So it is a characteristic features of stem. And also it do not have root cap and root hair. So that's why it will be confirmed that it is a stem, it's not a root. So here these are the different, the modified stem. Rhizome, bulb, tuber and cob. So first we are going to see the different type of the underground modified. First we are going to see the bulb. It is a condensed conical or convex stem. Condensed means it very much reduced. It's very much reduced. That is a condensed conical or the convex stem is surrounded by a fleshy scale leaves. So inside, you can see the onion. In the center region, it has a fleshy, that is juicy, seed-like structure. But the outer is a dry seed, scale leaves. Outer region is a dry scale leaves, but inside it is fleshy. The scale leaves are fleshy. It will overlap with one another, as is a form of bud-like structure. Even though the garlic, allium sativum, the garlic, it's also the outer have a dry scale is, but inner it is a juicy, fleshy. Okay. So the contents of conical or convex stem is surrounded by fleshy scale leaves. There are two types of the bulb, that is a tunicator, that is a what, the dry, in the outer it is a dry nature, but inner it is a fleshy and full fleshy form. So two type, tunicator and a fleshy bulb. First one, the tunicator or coated bulb. Tunicator or coated bulb, in which the stem is much condensed and is surrounded by several concentric layer of the scale leaves. It will overlap with one another. The entire structure, it will be covered a concentric layer of the scale leaves. The inner scales commonly, very commonly it is a fleshy, outer one is dry, like in onion and garlic. In onion and garlic, both the outer is a dry in nature, outer scale is a dry in nature, inner is fleshy. They can be, that is the bulb, tunicator bulb, if further classified into two types, that is a simple tunicator, example allium C for onion, and compound tunicator, example allium sativum, that is a garlic. Allium C4, that is a simple tunicator bulb, example allium C4, onion. Compound tunicator bulb, example allium sativum, garlic. Next type, underground modified, that is a corm. It is succulent underground stem with the erect growing tip. It is a circular underground stem, but the tip region, it have a erect region, it present outside the soil. So like that, it is erect stem, tip region. The corm is surrounded by the scale leaves, and very commonly it will be surrounded by scale leaves, and with experiment the node and the internode, both are present, node and the internode. So the presence of node and internode, scale leaf, so these are the characteristic features of stem. Example, Amaraphallus, Colocasia and Colsicum. So these are the example for the corm. Next, the third type is rhizome. So it is the underground stem, it is growing horizontally with a several lateral growing tip. Horizontally, it will grow horizontally with a several lateral growing tip. The rhizome possesses a conspicuous node and internode, is covered by scale leaves. Example, gingiber abyssinalis. Ginger, canna, that is generally called kalvali, cucumber lana, that means manjal, cucumber lana is a it's a manjal. Next, mesa, banana plant, mesa. So they have rhizome, they will be pollinating by means of rhizome. When the flower condition, it germinates to form a new young one. Next, tuber. This is a circular underground spherical or globular stem. Spherical or globular stem with many embedded axillary buds called eyes. So here, in potato, you see that many axillary buds, that is a green-like sprout will come out from some furrow region. So that is the embedded axillary, the furrow region is the axillary bud, so that is generally called eyes. Example, Solanum tuberosum and Helianthus tuberosum. Next, so that's all about the underground modified stem. Next, we are going to see the stem branching. So how the branches is occur? And how they are grow? Whether limited or unlimited. So based on that, it's further classified. Next, we are going to stem branching. So the branching pattern is determined by the relative activity of apical meristem. So the branching pattern is determined by the apical meristem. The mode of arrangement of branches on the stem is known as branching. Listen, the mode of arrangement of branches on the stem is known as branching. So there are two main types of the branching, that is lateral branching and dichotomous branching. So lateral means it will be grow in sideways. Dichotomous, it will be divided 2-2-2 like that. So it will be divided like that, again it will be divided like that. So that is di means two, dichotomous branching. Based on the growth pattern, so the lateral and the dichotomous branching, based on the growth pattern, the stems may be source of indeterminate and determinate growth. Indeterminate, it do not have any limited growth. Now continuously it will be grow. The apical part it will continuously grow. But indeterminate growth, the terminal part or apical part, it is the growth of the large growth of the stem. That is a determinate growth. Listen, what is an indeterminate? So here the terminal growth grow uninterrupted. Uninterrupted, it's not interrupted, it's uninterrupted. And it produces several lateral branches. The type of growth is often monopodial branching. Example, polyalgia. So here you can see that it is continuously grow and uninterrupted growth. The terminal bud, it will continuously grow. So as I said, what is happened? It will be produced as a lateral branching. So that is indeterminate. Next, determinate. The terminal bud sees the growth. Terminal bud, it will be stop the growth. Sees means it will be stop the growth after a period of growth. So when the plant grows certain height, after that the terminal bud appear, it will be sees the growth. So, the further growth is taken care by the successive or the several lateral meristem or buds. So, that means the branching. The successive, several lateral or what? The successive axillary buds. Either axillary bud or lateral buds. So, due to the lateral meristem. This type of the growth is also known as sympodial branching. So, indeterminate means monopodial. Determinate mean sympodial. Example, cycas. Example, cycas. So, thank you, student. That's all about the underground modified stem branching. So, in this video, we have finished with the root system. And next video, we are going to see the leaf. Thank you, student.